Now, our last video, we talked about advanced data security being a suite of features with Azure SQL for security purposes. Let's see it in action. Now, in the portal here, I've got my Azure database that I'm looking at, and I selected advanced data security. And you can see, just like we showed you in the last video, the three pillars of what this provides, data discovery and classification being one of them. And if I drill into this, you can see that by clicking on recommendations, Azure SQL is looking at column names and making recommendations on possible ways to classify your data. And for example, first name and last name may be something that matters for GDPR compliance. So you can select recommendations, you can save them. We're using behind the scenes the same T-SQL capabilities you have in SQL Server 2019 for this functionality, but you're able to view and see this all through the portal. The next element of advanced data security is vulnerability assessments. This is great functionality because we're using the knowledge of what we have on the SQL Server team using Azure to take a look at your configurations of your deployment and giving you recommendations. And we're giving you a scorecard here of these high risk, these medium, low risk, and should you take a look at these. For example, here's an element or a rule of vulnerability assessment that we flagged for firewall rules. Now, one thing you might find is it's possible that you'll look at a vulnerability assessment recommendation, decide this is actually okay for my environment. I would like this to not be flagged in the future. So you can actually approve it as a baseline so any future assessments would actually ignore this. Of course, if a change occurred, even based on your baseline, it would be flagged again. So I like that ability for you to get an initial assessment, go in and take a look at, decide what you think is okay in your environment, and establish those as baselines. Now, the final recommendation that we can look at is advanced threat protection. We mentioned this being machine learning services running in the cloud, looking at traffic coming into your Azure SQL database and giving you recommendations. Now, you can see here that I've got several different high alerts that have happened in my Azure SQL database. I want to take a look at that. One of those is SQL injection attacks. This is us looking behind the scenes at traffic coming in, SQL Server queries come into your environment, using machine learning and looking for possible queries that are considered SQL injections. Look right here. You can see this is a typical SQL injection example. Somehow, probably I had an app connected to my Azure SQL database that allowed a form to be filled out with a customer ID value. But somebody was clever to put it in a string combination into that value that allows me to do injection. Notice the clever use of the comments to terminate any future strings provided by my app. Imagine if in the middle of this was a drop table statement as part of this. So great example of SQL injection and us in the back end alerting to you. And the alerts could be in the forms of an email that you could see that something might have occurred in your environment that you need to take action to. So again, three great examples of advanced data security. Classify your data for compliance reasons. Do a vulnerability assessment to see about your configuration. Should you take advantage or should you take action on things to make your deployment more secure, and then enable advanced threat protection to get alerted to possible intrusion or SQL injection attacks against the deployment of Azure SQL database or your managed instance. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration of advanced data security. Check it out for your deployment. I highly encourage you to use this. Looking forward to seeing you in the next video.